Hi everyone, I'm Jose Mary on behalf of GenScript, and today we are interviewing iGEM Patras. So iGEM Patras, can you please tell us more about yourselves and your team's project?
Of course. We are very glad that we are finally making this interview with you, Jose Mary, and GenScript. As far as our team concerned, our team has a relatively short story, a short history. This year, we can actually start talking about a legacy. Last year was the first time that a team from the University of Patras and the city of Patras, in general, participated in the global iGEM synthetic biology competition. In which iGEM Patras managed to be awarded by receiving a silver medal. Now, do you want to tell you something about the members of our team? Or we can move on to our project. What do you want?
Sure, you could give us a brief overlook of some of your team members and then tell us more about your team's project, the issue that you're trying to address, and the design and approach that you're taking.
Okay, perfect. So, you know, from all the teams that for more efficient and effective work, we were divided in some teams, okay, based on what it is better, who is better on which part of the competition is one of us. Of course, at the same time, there is interaction between all of us as our individual tasks are interrelated, I can say. Okay, so we have the SAM team of wet lab that deals with the experimental part of our project, and it consists of George, Eva, and Alexandra. And the dry lab sub-team that consists of Jordan and Kostas, who are dealing with the modeling of our project. We also have a fundraising team, because fundraising is a big part of every iGEM team. Okay, money moves the world. Okay, so we need a team focusing on where to find money in order to buy our experimental stuff and things like this. So Vasya, Lefteris, and Kostas are the members of the sub-teams. And there is also the public relations team, sub-team with Maria and Ariadne, that deals not only with the promotion of our team and our activities on social media, but also with the human practices part of the competition. And of course, we should not forget to mention our team's PIs, Mr. George Patrinos, the head of Laboratory of Pharmacogenomics and Personalized Therapy at the Department of Pharmacy of the University of Patras, and Mr. Vasilis Kostopoulos, professor and director of the Laboratory of Applied Engineering and Oscillations at the Department of Mechanical and Aeronautical Engineering at the University of Patras here. And the coordinators of our team and its sub-team are George, Maria, Vasya, and me. Stavroula, Diana, and Maria are instructors in our whole effort, while Yanis is our advisor. So, Eva, I think now we can proceed to the project and the scientific field we're facing and dealing with this year.
Okay. Well, hello from me also. I'm Evanthia. I am one of the members of the wet lab team. As Dimitris said before, I'm a pharmacist and currently a master's student at the Department of Pharmacy on our University of Patras. I can say that. Okay, so our project is based on the field of pharmacogenomics. I don't know if you know that field. It is the scientific field that studies how genes affect the person's response to drugs. And this is why for example, two people take the same drug, they might have a different effectiveness of the drug. The one might have toxicity because of the over-metabolizing of the drug, and the other might not metabolize the drug and do not, and in this case, we might have also yes, and also toxicity. So early pharmacogenomic platforms were confined to the analysis of common variants before prescribing drugs, such as PharmGKB, also FDA and EMA. However, it has been observed that certain patients, besides these guidelines, still suffer from adverse drug reactions. And according to the FDA, over 100,000 deaths annually are associated with drugs. Approximately, there are 200 pharmacogenes, 50 of which regulate the CYP450 enzyme expression. Two of the most important liver enzymes are CYP26 and CYP2C19, involved in the metabolism of certain prescribed drugs in the body, like antipsychotic drugs and antiplatelet agents like clopidogrel and stuff like this. It is important drugs. It is also noteworthy that for more than half of the pharmacogenes, rent novel variants account for the entire genetic variability. And the contribution of rare variants was found to be highly gene and drug specific. And this is the main idea. This basically lead us to our project, Pegasus, with a very specific goal in mind, creating a comprehensive pharmacogenetic panel via whole pharmacogene sequencing in order to propose the proper adjustment of drug dosage. We are using next generation sequencing and clinical data from patients with psychiatric disorders, and novel and rare variants were detected on those data. In order to further validate the functional effect of such variants, we will perform side-directed mutagenesis in eukaryotic cells, and the expression of CYP26 and CYP2C19 mutated proteins will be assessed, and determination of protein expression levels will be conducted with immunoblotting. Finally, we will also determine the activity of the enzymes, both CYP26 and CYP2C19. We will also use a portable NGS device in a compact size from the company Oxford Nanopore, and more specifically the Minion, in order to parallelly sequence common, rare, and novel variants. We chose this next generation device because the whole pharmacogene sequencing with this is cost saving and just as accurate as other NGS sequences. Further, the importance of the novel variants in the Greek population will be confirmed. This is the main idea of our project.
Thank you so much for telling us more about your project and your approach to analyzing pharmacogenetics to observe adverse reactions in different individuals. So what inspired your team to tackle this issue?
Eva, you want to answer or you want to leave it?
I think it's mainly the fact that through pharmacogenomics, I have, I think, a delay due to my bad internet connection. Well, I can answer it, I think.
Eva, if your internet connection is not bad, I can answer it too. Don't worry.
Okay, yes, answer it, or George.
Okay. So, Rosemary, we all know that using synthetic biology to address real world problems requires thoughtful engagement with the world. Okay. So, and the iGEM competition indeed encourages every team to spread their ideas, projects, and thoughts, both to scientists and to the general public. So, scientists and the general public inspired us to make this project, to deal with this project this year. I'll tell you what our team is trying to do. Referring to the human practice section of the competition, because the human practices is attached very closely to our project. We try in every step that we take through our project, or we are going to take through our project, to get advice and information from the experts. Advice and information that guide us to the right decisions and scientific pathways. Until this month, we already have come in contact with many institutions, laboratories that perform pharmacogenomic tests, institutional scientists and doctors, individual physicians with their own clinics, in order not only to give us a piece of advice on how we can transform our project to a better one, but also confirm to us that we're heading to the right direction as far as the problems we're trying to solve through every part of our project. I should not forget to mention the ethics and law committees that we came in contact also recently. But I'll tell you something. Through that process, we found out that some scientists have concerns, for example, about the GDPR. And we made the right changes to our mindset in order to avoid the social problems arising from our project. So you understand that one of the main reasons that we inspired our project and made it better is the scientists, is the public, as I'll explain later. Some physicians had objections also to the method we take samples for DNA extracting and pharmacogenomics testing, referring to us, for example, that it may be a very expensive and a slow method. But through dialogue and conversation, we either explain to them that some wet lab techniques are the best that we can use and they cannot change, but in other cases, we adapted aspects of our project to their remarks. Okay. What I'm trying to say is that we took this feedback seriously, because eventually it highlighted important technical and social, as I said, the issues that we have missed. And now we have reached the point that we present to you a whole project. However, this process and this inspiration, these human practices we are conducting does not stop here. Who knows, sometimes in the future months before the Giant Jamboree, we may face another problem that needs to be solved. And with the help of a scientist or a patient, may find the solution to it.
And after your team's extensive analysis of the effects certain drugs could have, What kind of impact do you think your discoveries could make in the long term, in the future, for medical knowledge in general?
Mm-hmm. George, do you want to answer to this question?
Yes, okay. I didn't listen before the Eva about explaining the project, but I think he mentioned the novel variants we have. So this is the first step. We want to add our novel variants to already existing databases and categorize it to certain alleles, star alleles. And also we want to characterize this variant, so it will be possible to add these mutations in already existing panels, and other scientists can adapt this polymorphism into their diagnosis or into their scientific projects, etc. This is the first one. And second, we want to make pharmacogenomics more closer to the people, let's say, so everyone can do a pharmacogenomic test without very much money, and we want also to adapt a pharmacogenomic test into the government or insurance companies, so it's easier for the people to perform such an analysis. I think these two future steps for our project.
Josemary, allow me to say something here. As George mentioned, the patients is the main target, let's say, that we want to help. So hearing George referring to patients, I want to say that human practices, as I said before, does not have to do only with scientists. The community and the patients in our case, in our project, plays a big role in the progress of our team project. For a start, I'll say to you what we did in order to see what patients believe about our project, because they are the ones that we want to make pharmacogenomics and pharmacogenomic tests available and accessible to. So for a start, we have already made and distributed questionnaires, mainly through our social media and site, in order to get information about the knowledge ordinary people have upon pharmacogenomics. After explaining them all the proper information, we asked the public through these questionnaires if they know what this scientific field is about, what are their thoughts on having a pharmacogenomic test before taking a drug, prescribing a drug, may cause adverse drug reactions, and after explaining them all the proper information again, we ask the public to tell us how useful this test seem to them, and if they happen to have used it, what they would have changed. The feedback was and is, because this process is going on, very good and useful for us, since it gave us the strength to carry on in our project, as we saw that people would encourage their doctors to apply to them such a test. I would like to announce a little teaser that our team is going to organize more human practices like this, referring related to the public, the patients and our community in general. So get ready. Stay tuned.
Well, iGEM Patras, thank you so much for meeting with me today to tell us more about yourselves, your team, and your team's project. I think it will definitely have a tremendous impact to change how we think about the pharmacogenetics and how it affects certain individuals, and certainly add value to how pharmaceuticals are prescribed and how they can affect each person. And have definitely extend that impact globally as well. Thank you so much for meeting with me.
Hopefully.
Best of luck in the iGEM 2021 Jamboree and best of luck in the iGEM 2021 sponsorship competition by GenScript.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for meeting with me.